Allie Mitchell?
Yes. Are you a school dad? Sorry, there's so many, but I feel like we've met before.
This is awkward, but I'm here about Katie.
Is something wrong? Did something happen at school?
No, nothing like that. Katie was born at St. Mary's between March 27th and the 29th. 15 years ago, isn't that right?
I don't know what you're selling, but this is creepy, and we're not...
My wife died. Sorry. This is weird, I know. I'm Tom Truby. Would it be okay if I come in? We really need to talk.
Hello.
Hi, Tom Truby.
Jeff Mitchell.
Of course, I know who you are.
If this is about my work, I prefer inquiries to go through my agency.
Oh, that's not why I'm here. This is an impressive home. And, such a beautiful child.
Then why are you here? I'm very sorry about your wife, but what does this have to do with Katie?
Bella had ovarian cancer. She had a genetic mutation in the BRCA gene that we didn't know until it was too late. After Bella died, I had our 3 kids tested for the mutation. They all tested negative. But my 15-year-old Liv, she wasn't a match at all.
Not sure I follow.
Liv is not a match for my DNA. Or my wife's. She's not our child. Biologically, I mean, of course, I adore Liv, but I think you have my baby. There must have been a mix-up at the hospital.
No, there's no way.
There were 9 babies born at St. Mary's between the 27th and 29th. 6 were boys, and the only other girl was a different ethnicity. You'll need to do a DNA test. And if I'm right, you'll probably want to get Katie tested for the BRCA mutation as soon as
possible. The bracelets. Katie had a little bracelet in the hospital that matched the one I had.
Liv was a preemie. Yeah, she went straight to the intensive care. St. Mary's doesn't put the bracelet on until the baby's considered stable.
Katie was premature, too. I think you need to leave.
Okay. Just let me give you my number.
Just go. Please.